old-time cowboys, they listen to my song. Please do not grow weary, I will not detain you long. Concerning some young cowboy who did agree to go, spend the summer pleasantly on the trail of the buffalo. Well, I found myself in Griffin. It was in the year of 83. But a world-famous drover come a-walking up to me, saying, "How'd you do, young cowboy? How'd you like to go spend the summer pleasantly on the trail of the buffalo?" Well, me being out of work right then, this drover I did say, "This going out on buffalo range, well, it depends upon your pay. But if you pay good wages, transportation to and fro, I think I might go with you on the hunt of the buffalo." "Well, oh yes, I will pay good wages and your transportation too, if you'll agree to work for me until the season's through, until the season's through. But if you do get homesick and try to run away, or even starve to death on the prairie, you lose all your pay. With all this flattering talking, he's signed up quite a train. Something 10 to 12 in number, some able-bodied men. Well, our trip, it was a pleasant one, as we hit the western road, until we hit old Boggy Creek, up in old New Mexico. Well, there our pleasures ended, boys, and our troubles, they begun. A lightning storm did hit us, it made the cattle run. Well, that good old fool of stickers from the cactus that did grow, and outlaws watching to pick us off from the hills of the buffalo. Well, our working season ended, but the drover would not pay. He said, "You went and drunk too much, you're all in debt to me." But the cowboys never did hear of such a thing as a bankruptcy law, so we left the drover's bones to bleach on the hills of the buffalo.